On March 25, 1971, the first prototype of the post-war Soviet largest military transport aircraft made its maiden flight. Up to now, half a century has passed. The Ilyushin Il-76 from the Soviet era is still in use globally in both civilian and military roles. The Il-76 has demonstrated a worldwide success story with an estimated 1,000 produced in all versions. Airframe is designed to be surprisingly adaptable to all customer needs in different roles. Il-76 is quietly used in Europe, Asia, and Africa. Its main role is military and civilian transport, including the transport of military paratroopers or civilian passengers, as well as the heavy cargo. In addition, it also performs other roles such as electronic intelligence, a WAX, airborne hospital, electronic countermeasures, aerial refueling, etc. The Il-76 is operated by a crew of 5 to 7 people, depending on the requirements of the mission, including the pilot, co-pilot, navigator, flight engineer, communications officer, and cargo handlers. It measures 46.59 meters long, a wingspan of 50.5 meters, and height is 14.76 meters. The empty weight of the Il-76 is from 92.5 tons to 104 tons, depending on the version, and the maximum takeoff weight is 195 tons to 210 tons. The payload capacity can reach from 42 tons to 60 tons, depending on the version. Basically, the Il-76 possesses the characteristic design of the Soviet Cold War aircraft. It may not be the prettiest plane, but very practical, able to operate from short and unprepared airstrips, and capable of coping with the worst weather conditions likely to be experienced in Siberia and the Soviet Union's Arctic regions. Wings are high-mounted across the top of the fuselage, swept aft and clipped at the tips, and noted by their burnished center portion atop the aircraft. Beneath the wings are the engines, two on each side. The empennage was dominated by the single-axis aerial vertical tail fin, to which a T-style wing arrangement was applied. The horizontal planes were mounted at the extreme top of the vertical tail, completing the Il-76 unique look. Loading and unloading cargo is done through the rear ramp of the aircraft, with two vertical doors hinged along the outside edges. The popular version of the family is the Il-76TD, which is powered by 4 Soloviev D-30KP turbofans with 117.7 kN thrust each. It can reach a top speed of 900 km per hour with a range of 4,000 km and a service ceiling of 13,000 meters. Il-76 did not have time for the Vietnam War, but it was to a large extent its product. But after Vietnam, he did not miss a single more or less noticeable military conflict, not in the territory of his native country, nor in the many countries outside of its borders. Between 1979 and 1991, the Soviet Air Force Il-76 made 14,700 flights into Afghanistan, transporting 786,200 servicemen and 315,800 tons of freight. The Il-76 carried 89% of Soviet troops and 74% of the freight that was airlifted. Since its inception in the middle 1970s to the present, the Il-76 is the main military transport aircraft of the Soviet Union and Russia, and continues to be modernized. There are also many other operators around the world, including the United States, China, India, several Middle Eastern and African countries, and even the North Korean Air Force currently operates 3 Il-76. The Il-76 will probably remain for them for quite a long time, given the machine's modernization potential, which becomes so valuable to countries with limited financial resources. My video about Ilyushin Il-76 answer. Thank you for watching. If you find this video interesting, please give me your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to support the channel. Goodbye and see you again in the next videos.